Was the biggest cruise ship in the world really a good time? Find out my three loves and three hates up next. Hi, it's Melissa here at Ready to Go, where we discuss tips and resources to help you plan your very own travels and create unforgettable memories and experiences. Royal Caribbean's Wonder of the Seas will remain the largest cruise ship in the world until January 2024, when the Icon class is launched. The ship fats 362 meters or 1,187 feet in length, 236,000 tons, 18 decks, a capacity of up to 7,084 passengers plus 2,369 crew members, lots of space and surprisingly lots of areas where you can have some quiet time if you so wish. Plenty of lounge chairs around the four different pool decks. We were always able to find hot tubs that were not overcrowded. And Royal does a good job at organizing activities in different areas of the ship, so we never really felt crowded. Let's look at what were my favorite parts of this cruise and where there could be some room for improvement. Now stay tuned, as at the end of this video, I'll show you the port stops we had on our Eastern Caribbean itinerary. Now, if you're liking this video so far, please give it a like. And if you've been on a cruise recently, please write up your own loves and hates in the comments below. Okay, let's go. Let's begin our top three countdown of what I absolutely loved about this ship. Number three, you can't be bored once on board. Wonder of the Seas holds eight unique neighborhoods with a big variety of activities. Central Park is an outdoor park with real plants and trees among several specialty restaurants, shops, and park seating areas. Take a ride on the Rising Tide Bar, which descends to the Royal Promenade on Deck 5. Grab an evening drink at Trellis Bar and head to the music hall next to this area, which features live musical acts. The pool and sports zone. In the pool zone, you have four pools, many hot tubs, the perfect storm water slides, splash away bay for kids, a large poolside movie screen, and an astronaut. The adults only 18 plus solarium at the very front of the ship is one of my favorite spots, with pools, hot tubs, a bar, and a bistro buffet. You get great views from here. In the sports zone, you'll find the famous Flow Rider surf simulator at the back of the ship, the Wonder Dunes mini golf, zip line crossing 10 decks high, two rock climbing walls, a sports court, and the entrance to the tallest slide at sea, the Ultimate Abyss, which slides you all the way down to our next neighborhood, the Boardwalk. The boardwalk is meant to look like an old-school boardwalk with a complimentary carousel open day and night, an arcade, a sports bar, ice cream shop, hot dog station, and a retro Johnny Rockets burger joint. Entertainment place includes the Royal Theater, Studio B ice skating rink, also used for special shows and laser tag, the Attic Comedy Club. They also have bingo here during the day. This area also has the private Crown Lounge, which is for Diamond, Diamond Plus, and Pinnacle members of the Crown & Anchor loyalty program. The Casino Royale is also located in this area. Royal Promenade. This is the main area that you enter when boarding. It's a little like the downtown part of the ship. It has lots of service areas such as a photography studio, loyalty club desk, information booths, many duty-free shops, the Bolero's Latin-themed dance bar, a pub with a live guitarist, the Bionic Bar with its robotic bartender, the Schooner Bar with live pianist and daily trivia contests, and the always full Spotlight Karaoke Bar. They also have parades and balloon drops here. While you're here, remember to stop by the next cruise office to book, you guessed it, your next cruise. The Vitality Spa and Fitness Center. Here you'll find the thermal suite with different steam rooms for which you can buy a pass. They offer facial and body services, including manicures, pedicures, massages, and acupuncture, a beauty salon, and a barbershop. The fitness center is free and accessible to all cruisers. They also offer fitness classes for which you can purchase a pass. The Youth Zone. Adventure Ocean provides all-day fun, and they will take care of infants as young as 6 months old all the way to teenagers with different activity areas by age group. There is also a patio reserved for teens aged 13 to 17. And finally, the Suite Class neighborhood is located high up on deck 17 and 18 with a private plunge pool, a bar, the Suite Lounge, and the Suites-only restaurant called Coastal Kitchen. The second thing I loved about the ship were the dining options. You have 11 places that are included for food and snack options, including the main dining room, the Windjammer Buffet, El Loco Fresh, which is quick Mexican eats, the Solarium Bistro, Sorrento's Pizza, because who doesn't love free pizza, the Park Cafe, Cafe Promenade, the Boardwalk Doghouse. You also have Sprinkles Soft Serve Ice Cream Station near the pool area. You can get free breakfast at Johnny Rockets. And in the Vitality Cafe in the spa area, they also offer complimentary granola bars, muffins, and finger foods. Now, if you'd like to indulge in some specialty dining options, you also have these other 13 venues. The Mason Jar for yummy Southern eats. Hooked Seafood. Wonderland with its magical and creative dishes, Giovanni's Italian Kitchen and Wine Bar, 150 Central Park for more high-end dining, Chops Grill, which is the ship's steakhouse, Izumi Sushi, the Izumi Hibachi Grill, Johnny Rocket's Old School Burger Joint, Playmaker's Sports Bar and Arcade, Sugar Beach Candy and Ice Cream Shop, a Starbucks kiosk, and Coastal Kitchen, which is reserved for suite guests. Now, what was the number one thing I loved about Wonder of the Seas? We'll save that for the end. In the meantime, we'll discuss the three hates, or let's say the three things I enjoyed the least about this cruise. Number three, children in adults-only area. Royal Caribbean does a great job at providing a ton of family-friendly areas. There are essentially only two areas that are adults-only, these being the casino and the solarium. Now, on several occasions, there were children running around the solarium, even right in front of the bar and the towel station, but there was literally no reaction from the crew members working there. Just like I would not be allowed onto the teen patio, the same rule should apply here. Number two, prices for extras such as excursions, cabanas, and drink packages. What is up with these prices on the Oasis class? Like, for two people wanting to take a drink package, you're spending over $1,000 for 1 week just for drinks. I find that it's a little bit of an exaggeration, but hey, the free market is the free market. And now the final thing I did not enjoy so much about this ship, although it is a beautiful cruise ship, is that it has very little focus on outdoor and ocean views. Aside from the pools and sports area, all the other venues and activities on the ship are indoors. Even the outdoor area of the boardwalk is very inward looking. You can't really see the wake at the back of the ship as it's blocked by the aqua theater. I also found the location of the walking track to be a little odd. It's on deck 5, which is covered. I guess that's great for rainy days. However, you don't really get to enjoy the sunshine and being outdoors when you're on the walking track. It's also on the same level as the lifeboats, so when you're walking around the ship, your view is often blocked by these lifeboats. Now, it does have some cool spots, especially at the back where you can see the wake. I think I just like walking tracks that are more out in the open. So, should there be an amplification of this ship at any point in the future? In my opinion, this would be the one area of improvement to look into. Okay, and now as I promised, what was my number one love on Wonder of the Seas? By far, it's the world-class entertainment that is all included in your fare. First and foremost, you have the aqua shows in the aqua theater at night, with acrobatics and high diving. You have stand-up comedy shows every night. There's a unique show called The Effectors 2, which is a high-tech Broadway-style performance. Tap Factory, a unique show highlighting percussion theater and various other talented performers. An ice skating show, the Love and Marriage show, a veterans tribute, and we even got to see a Kitchen Nightmares competition. So you've got at least a different show for every day of the week, and this provides really top value, as it would cost you thousands of dollars to see all of these on land and quite challenging to do it all within the same week. There you have my three loves and three hates of Wonder of the Seas. And now for our bonus item, as promised, here are the port stops we enjoyed on our Eastern Caribbean itinerary. So our first stop was in St. Thomas. This was my first time there, and there were many recommendations to visit Megan's Bay, which the excursion description claimed is one of the top five beaches in the world. Now, I will respectfully disagree with this, as at least on that day, it was very overcrowded. It's not a very big beach. It took me only 15 minutes to walk from one end to the other. The food stand was total chaos. It took almost an hour to get our food, and the bathrooms were not very clean. So I was not a fan of Megan's Bay. Perhaps it is quite beautiful when no one's around. Our second stop was in St. Martin, which is by far one of my favorite islands in the Caribbean. I had already been there on a resort vacation and explored the island. So on this trip, we decided to burn some of those buffet calories and joined an excursion for a coastal hike. I can't recommend this enough if you're someone who likes to get some movement in and enjoy the cliffside ocean views. And finally, we ended on Perfect Day at Coco Key, which is Royal Caribbean's private island, considered the top cruise island in the world. You can find lots of videos about this place, and here you'll find four beaches, the largest lagoon pool in the Caribbean, a water park, which is an extra charge, and several barbecue buffet and snack shacks all around, which are included as part of your cruise package. In 2024, they'll also be opening a new adults-only area called Hideaway Beach. It really was a perfect day and a perfect way to end our vacation. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you learned something new, please share it to your socials so that your friends and family can see it as well. And to make sure you never miss out on new videos, please subscribe to the channel and ring the bell. This way, you're always ready to go.